to discuss not just build, but also in the last few days, he's been exposing what he calls questionable costs, deals, and now to reveal a questionable loan. We have Senate Minority Leader Franklin Drilon is with us this morning. Senator Drilon, thank you so much for coming to Head Start.
Karen, thank you very much for inviting me on your birthday. Happy birthday.
Thank you.
Karen.
Thank you. Well, thank you for coming. That's one, because I know that you've been busy in the Senate. Yeah. Before we talk about build, you first, I was going to ask you about that. You wanted to first discuss what you've discovered regarding the SEA Games, okay? You've already questioned, number one, the 55 million peso cauldron, which you said was too much.
Billion, not million.
The cold
million, a million,
million,
yes,
yeah,
yes.
Which you said was extravagant,
yes.
And also questioning the cost of the sea of the refurbishing, the SEA Games cost, which was 6 billion, and refurbishing Rizal Memorial, which you could have said would have been okay for 1.2 billion. All right, let's start now from what you've discovered again.
Yes, first they have built a caldero. Of a 50 million caldero in New Clark City for the opening of the games. Mm. 50 million in that structure, which will be lighted to mark the opening. I question the propriety. 50 million plus another 5 million for the fuel that will be used, because they built the caldero in Clark in the sports stadium, but the opening will be in Bulacan, 95 kilometers away or 90 kilometers away. They will have the opening, so the what the athletes will see in Bulacan, where the opening will be, is a TV screen with the caldero being lighted.
No, now, so what you're trying to say is when the cauldron is lit, that is not where the athletes will be. It is not the opening of the games. It won't be there.
It will be in Bulacan.
Okay, that's one.
So they will spend 5 million just for the gas. All right. So the total, the capital outlay is 50 million to build that structure, consisting of a 4.4 million designed by National
Bobby Mañosa.
Bobby Mañosa, a 13.4 million for the foundation alone, and 32 million for the construction. That brings it to a total of roughly 50 million plus the 5 million in the lighting.
Okay, all right. But then you do have other responses. Like, for example, Speaker Alan Peter Cayetano says that, you know, there's a whole spirit to it. That memory of when the SEA Games open, that cauldron is lit, it's also symbolic. Mm-hmm. Congressman Joey Salceda said, yes, it may be imeldific, but it's, in a way, it's the symbol of the country going out into the world.
Fine. Maybe they're correct. The issue is the propriety.
Okay.
Spending that much for a caldero. Remember that we, in this budget this year, we have a deficit of 624 billion pesos, for which we have to borrow in order to finance that deficit at an interest rate I don't know how much,
okay.
But part of that deficit, or 2.5% of that deficit, will be the cost of staging these games.
Is it staging or building New Clark City? I want you to clarify.
Okay, building the Clark is 9.5 billion. Mm-hmm. The other facilities that will be used, another 5 billion. All right. Now, apart from that, there is...
Just to clarify.
Yes.
What's reported is there was a lump sum of 6 billion pesos for the SEA Games.
Yes.
Was that for building New Clark City or just for the games itself?
That 6 billion went to the Philippine Sports Commission. Out of that 6 billion, 1 billion was transferred to the foundation and the BCDA to build not only Clark, but also the other sports facilities that had to be refurbished. So for capital outlay alone, for capital outlay, a total of approximately 10.5 billion pesos, 1 billion of which came from Philippine Sports Commission budget, and the remaining of this 6 billion after the 1 billion is approximately 5 billion, which is now used for expenses in the actual staging of the game.
All right, but what you were talking about is the new Clark City Stadium, that whole facility.
Yes.
That was not part of the 6 billion.
That 9.5 billion is for that facility alone. Another 1 billion for facilities was also spent out of the budget of the Philippine Sports Commission.
Okay.
The 9.5 billion came from the budget from the funds of the BCDA.
Okay, so it's a total of 10 billion, is that correct?
10.5.
10.5. So
yes.
6 billion lump sum, 3 billion BCDA.
No.
Go on.
No, sorry.
Can you clarify?
Clarify.
Okay.
The total expense for the facilities is roughly 10.5.
Separate from the 6 billion.
Let me finish.
Okay.
That 10.5 was came from 9.5 billion contributed by BCDA, and another 1 billion coming from the 6 billion of the Philippine Sports Commission.
All right.
So the 1 billion came from the 6 billion of the Philippine Sports Commission as augmentation for the capital outlay, meaning for the facilities.
Yes.
The remaining 5 billion is what what they will use for staging the games.
Okay, now, before the staging, viewers might be asking, all right, so it came from BCDA, what makes that questionable?
Well, the luxury, I repeat.
That's one.
That's why, you know, we have a deficit of 624 billion, 9.5 or 10 billion of that will be because of the facilities that we build. Number two, we are incurring a loan here. Inutang natin ito, from a Malaysian bank. 2.2 payable in 5 years' time at 2.2 billion per year. So that's a total of 11 billion. So it was financed by borrowing, mind you. So that is why when Boots Ramirez testified in the Senate, he said renovating the Rizal Memorial Coliseum, we would to put it to international standards, we would have spent only 1.2 billion. So I question the propriety of spending this kind of money for this kind of a facility.
Okay, but then why bring this up? You may have observers saying, why is Senator Drilon bringing this up now, a few weeks before the Southeast Asian Games, when you would want the country united, cheering for the Philippines, if you really believe that there was something inappropriate without the BCDA handled New Clark City? Why didn't the Senate, in reviewing the budget, see this 2 years ago?
We are reviewing the budget only now, because it is budget time. And number two, we are questioning not the staging of the games, but the amount of money being spent just to stage the games.
And this,
second, Roy, let me finish. You know, we are in support of the athletes.
Yeah.
That we made that very clear. But we were asking questions in the course of the debates on the budget of BCDA. So it is not as if we bring it out only now. The budget of the BCDA was a lump sum budget. We did not see this 50 million caldero.
The budget of BCDA was lump sum of how much?
I do not recall anymore. But, you know, it has its own corporate budget. But the augmentation or the assistance to GOCCs under the budget was part of it was to BCDA for, I think, at least $9.5 billion for the structures in New Clark City.
Now, someone might argue, the BCDA might argue, that's the whole reason they have a budget, is the budget is meant to be spent. And if you go to New Clark City, it's quite impressive. You go to the facilities, it's a class one sports facility. Yes. There's swimming and track, but the facility itself is impressive. It puts the Philippines in the level of like a Singapore or Hong Kong when you look at the facility. Mm-hmm. And Senator Pia Cayetano says Filipino athletes deserve a first class sports facility. Mm-hmm. Speaker Cayetano says it will not be a white elephant, it will be used. And it's also developing New Clark City. Yes. So my question is, was BCDA wrong in spending their own budget in the way they saw fit?
This is not the budget of the BCDA. This is the money of the Filipino people. And in fact, we are borrowing, and we will incurring just for this about $11 billion in borrowing, which we will repay in 4 years' time. So it is not the money of BCDA, and it is only an authorization to spend. So you are supposed, you are given authority. Will you luxuriously spend it, or will you spend it in a manner that will bring the same prestige to our country, but at a much lesser cost? I repeat, no less than the PSC chairman, Butch Ramirez, said, by renovating the Rizal Coliseum, we will spend only 1.2 billion pesos, and we will bring it to international standards. So it's a question of propriety. Yes, there is authority, no question about it. And by the way, they also formed the so-called FISGOC Foundation, where 1.5 billion was transferred to run the games. 1.5 billion to a private foundation. You know, let me put on record, put a warning to PSC, which moved this. Governor Grace Padaca last week was convicted of malversation for passing on government funds to a foundation in Isabela. So just a fair warning to everyone that, yes, there are authorities. There was an authority in the form of the budget. But remember, we have laws to follow insofar as spending of public funds are concerned. Mm.
So based on that, you believe, because FISGOC, you have, I think, Speaker Alan Cayetano as the chair, right? And I think Vince Dison is also in FISGOC. And yes, members of the PSC, are you saying that they could, cases could be filed against them for graft?
I am not saying that. I am just citing that extreme caution should be exercised, because just last week, Grace Padaca was convicted for transferring provincial funds of Isabela to a private foundation.
Viewers might be wondering how the BCDA could have, because building New Clark City and the facilities essentially at least took maybe a year and a half to 2 years. Mm. So what is lacking in the processes in government? Because you could have Vince Dizon watching and saying, wait, when we were building it, we were allowed to build it. Nobody stopped us from building it. Nobody said what we were building was wrong. We were showing off on television the facilities, and I didn't hear senators saying, where are you going to get the money for that, etc., right?
No, we're not saying we're going to get the money. They have the authorization. Expense, the luxury is what we're raising.
So, no, my question is, why wasn't it brought up before it was built, when they showed the plans of this facility? That's my question. In other words, BCDA showed off the plans. They even brought it here on the Head Start.
Yes.
So everybody knew that this is what New Clark City is.
Yes.
So my question is, why wasn't it stopped before it was built? Why is it being raised only now?
I will repeat. Why is it being raised only now? No, when the budget is just being discussed now, the utilization of the present budget is being discussed now. The fact that they showed it off before doesn't change anything. And by the way, that is our system. The audit takes place after the expense is incurred. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. The Commission on Audit will audit the expenditure after we after it is spent.
Okay,
that's
now,
our system.
All right. I know you want a Senate hearing on this, but two quick questions for you, and I hope you can clarify this. Okay. In terms of BCDA taking a loan from, is it a Malaysian bank, you said?
Yes.
To build new Clark City, that act in itself, would that be considered illegal?
No.
All right, number
one. I'm just talking about where the funds came from.
But
that we had to borrow to build this.
So that's one.
Yes.
So technically, the act of borrowing to build New Clark City is not illegal.
I never said that.
Okay.
I'm just saying that's where the funds were sourced. We had to borrow $11 billion in order to build that facility.
Okay, but the other question is, the amount that was borrowed, if you find out that it was not spent prudently in terms of expenses, cost of bill, could that be an anomalous act of somehow? Like, for example, if the cauldron, in your hearing, they'll discover it could have been built for less.
I don't know.
Okay.
I do not know if it can be built for less. We are just saying that it's a 50 million caldero plus 5 million in fuel. Is this appropriate? Is this is the propriety there? We can use that to build 50 classrooms. And by the way, the deputy chief of mission of Team Philippines, Stephen Fernandez, he was a member of the Philippine Olympic Committee Board, said it would be probably brought in by helicopter because they will not show it in, they will show it in an arena 90 kilometers away from where the games will be open in Bulacan. So if you can imagine that the very people, the Philippine Olympic Committee people, and by the way, I'm sorry, it is not Fernandez, it is Hontiveros,
okay.
Steve Hontiveros. And they did not know, the PSA did not know how expensive this caldero will be.
Okay, but Senator, since you've been exposing this and now you're saying on Head Start that building New Clark City was coming from a loan, no?
Yes.
So it's not part of the national budget in effect.
No, it is part of the budget, but the budget was financed through a loan.
Okay, and now what you're saying, it's become part of a deficit. Essentially,
yes.
That's
of course. Yes.
Okay, but all these exposés, okay, you've said it's inappropriate, but who do you believe should be accountable for it? Because you can't come out and say all of this and not say who you believe is accountable. Who should the people call? Who do you believe?
After the games, then we will conduct the investigation.
Okay.
We don't want to conduct the investigation now.
During the games.
During
of
the
course.
Games, yes.
So
yes.
After the games, you will conduct an investigation.
Yes, the Senate will.
Yeah. And when the investigation is conducted, essentially, what do you want to get to the bottom of? What do you want to achieve?
We will look at every angle. We will look at whether or not it is there is propriety, whether there is luxury, there is graft and corruption. But then here, the COA will be the one to lead the audit of the funds. That's the role.
Okay. All right. Moving on from the games, you were also quoted this week as criticizing Build, saying it was a dismal failure, where you have cabinet members, pro-government advocates saying essentially that was unfair, it was extreme. Bayani Fernando said it's slow, some have said it's a work in progress.
Yeah.
I had the OTR Secretary Tugade here yesterday.
Mm-hmm.
Will you vote for the slashing of the budget of the DOTR, a 60 billion peso slash?
I'm not aware that the Senate slashed it.
Okay.
The slashing may have been done in the Department of Budget, not in the Senate. But let me double check that.
Yeah.
In other words, I'm not aware that the committee, I'm not sure.
Uh-oh.
It may be that the committee slashed. I'm not sure of that. But the underspending is reported by the COA itself.
Okay.
Okay.
All
where
right.
They said that only about 25 pesos out of the 100 pesos appropriated is spent.